What comes to your mind when you think of belonging? Warmness, family, a sense of existence, peer group, or emotional connection. For us, we regard belonging as a kind of emotional connection. Where does the belonging come from? It's my life in the long-time interaction between people. It is a kind of feeling that not only makes you feel warm, but also builds a strong relationship on one another. Besides, we can share our feelings by communicating with our family and friends to create such a thing. Living in such a friendly and incredibly interactive environment, we definitely gain acceptance.
Just like Barbara, the girl who was born and raised up in the urban city. In her eyes, although there were always so many people around, there was little interaction among them. People were so lukewarm that she somehow felt empty in the crowd, as though she had lost something. The same feeling occurred to Barbara when she took the elevator. She often felt awkward to encounter her neighbors in the elevator. Although the people was her neighbor living the opposite of her place, they treated each other just like strangers. A place consisting of indifferent people is just like a piece of infertile land with no vitality. Feeling like building an emotional connection between people, Barbara suddenly realized that the thing she lost was an emotion called belonging.
Feeling such emptiness, she typed belonging in the search column. Pieces of information flit across her sight, and one of them attracted her attention. Military Kindred Village. Out of curiosity, Barbara clicked the website. On the website were the background, the cause and effect of the Military Kindred Village rebuilding plan written by the initiator. From 1949 to 1960s. Because of the failure in the Second Chinese Civil War, lots of soldiers in the Republic of China military and their families followed the government when it immigrated to Taiwan. The village the government built for them was named Military Kindred Village. Such a little place became the mainlanders' own small world. Having no interaction with local Taiwanese, they still kept their cultural customs.
Zhong 村很像是一个民主的大熔炉，因为里面的成员来自四面八方，天南地北，都从中国大陆随着军队迁到台湾来的，所以呢，各省的人都有，乡音也非常的复杂，生活习惯也都不同，不相同，却因为战争的缘故，大家聚在一个小小的地方，因为大家的职业相同。父亲多半都是军人，有共同的生活习惯，共同的信仰跟乡愁，所以团结性跟一致性跟别的族群来比较的话，当然是比较紧密的。
People can easily resonate with each other because they came from the same background. People who live in military kindred village pour their hearts out to their neighbors.Via deep conversations and express their emotions of nostalgia. As if the place where they live now is their hometown. People are so close to each other, including not only families but also the neighbors. Residents there can find warmness, friendship, and the human touch. Gradually, people became more and more dependent on military kindred village. Hence, many people living there, even those who have ever lived there,came forward for their homes when they came face to face with the crisis of demolition. They tried their best to keep this meaningful place with transformation, reconstruction, and preservation in order to save the place that will always be their home in their minds.
After Barbara read the history of Military Kindred Village, she realized that if she wants to find her own belonging,She should begin with having communication, sharing experiences with others, and sympathizing with others' feelings. As time went by, trust and reliance would be gradually developed between people, and she could find her own belonging for her community. Barbara decided to start from herself. In the morning, opening the door, Barbara greeted her family and neighbors with a big smile. Good morning!